So Kevin's going to stand here next to me to answer any technical questions, since I won't be able to do any justice to it, so I'll just... All right, so the goal of this presentation is just going to be to talk about some of the new products and features that we've introduced in the, maybe the past 12, 16, 18 months. I know this is going to be old news for probably most of you, but the goal is to kind of remind you of some of the new things that are out that maybe you don't have, so that now that you have a chance to tinker around here, you can maybe ask some questions and see if it's right for you or right for your customers, and if it's maybe something you want to push in email and other marketing. First of all, thanks to Georgie. Where's the elastomer guys here? Okay, yeah. So this picture is actually of the brand new LED video display, and that this was taken a world record in Russia maybe a month ago. Is that right, Georgie? So we got this via Instagram, and it's one of the few pictures that we've gotten of the display out in the field. And we love that it's the Russian characters as well. So you can see the 356. I mean, that's something I used to run back in high school, but I can't quite break 4 minutes anymore. But I'd say in general, really impressive time. So it's beautiful. We'd love to see a picture like that of a world-class athlete with a world record standing next to a link sign, and encourage you guys to do the same thing as well. And then next to it there, we have a very souped up Vision Pro camera. Paul Lambert, our horse racing expert, loves to take just glamour shots. He has a booth in his house where he just adds in more contraptions on top of the pros to make it just look beautiful. So I think there's the electronic viewfinder there, there's a GPS, there's a nice big lens, and we think that it is a nice, beautiful marketing shot there. All right, so let's get going. All right, so just want to start with the product development background here. Like I mentioned, this is going to be our 26th year now. We actually just had our anniversary 2 or 3 days ago. And we started with the 800 frames per second Silver Bullet, which I know some of you have probably seen before or maybe even owned, but that's that beautiful camera right there. And then next to it is actually the original DOS version of FinishLinks, which I think is just a thing of beauty as well. So we dug up actually a lot of these old images last year when we did the 25th anniversary post. We talked to maybe 25 plus old customers and partners and collected some great stories. So I encourage you to check out the blog post on the website just to see some more old school tech photos. I think they're great. So like I said, we started with the Silver Bullet, but we continue to push the limits of hard drives and peripherals. Essentially, we are making the products as fast as we can, and the goal is to, between Identilinks and huge captures, you might need an SSD drive to keep up, and the goal is to keep pushing that with more powerful products. And because computers have gotten better, we're able to then make more powerful products to keep up with that as well. So, and then like Ed mentioned, we're backwards compatible, so we're still supporting cameras that are 20 plus years old, which, if you get a Samsung phone, I don't think that'll be working in 20 years. So I think we're rare in that respect, and we like to pat ourselves on the back a little bit. And then really the goal is to make fully automatic timing easier for all. That was part of the original mission statement, to bring this high-class technology to every local store. So, all right, and then, so here's some more old school photos, actually. So Philippe can't be here, but this is an original, the first Tour de France. I don't know if Doug is here somewhere. Is that right, Doug? The first Tour de France you went to? Yeah. There you go, right? Nice crew cut there.
Yeah, some young guy.
And so that's with the, I believe, yeah, the Tour de France and the original Mat Sport team there. And then this is a photo from Roger at university meet. I don't know if that sounds right.
Yeah, NCAA championship.
And I just love the gigantic monitors and the little silver bullet there. I think this is just, I can look at these all day. But again, the philosophy here is what Ed already kind of mentioned, where we're making powerful and reliable sports timing systems, and we're trying to bring that new technology to every level of sport, and I think we've done pretty well with that. The next, providing elegant solutions to common sports timing problems. And then I think another really important one is that we use open architecture design so that if you want to use another company's chip or wind gauge or scoreboard, we do our best and we try to interface with any technology that we can. Is that right, Kevin? If they're open, we're open. So yeah, sometimes you have to pull teeth to get the interface to work, but anyone, you know, when it's important to work, you know, there's chip companies like MyLabs or RaceResult or whatever, we do our best to make that seamless as possible. And then of course, finally, we incorporate user feedback. So I know some of you have a direct line to Doug where you can complain about something or offer a suggestion. And I think over the years, there's been some really important features that have made their way into the software and the hardware because the squeaky wheel gets the grease. So, you know, we try our best to then incorporate your feedback into the next round of updates. All right, so then basically the overview is we're gonna look at, first of all, the new vision camera packages, which I alluded to earlier. We overhauled every single sport with updated vision and vision pro packages, and then some of the actual accessories that go along with that. Next is the sort of Vision Pro camera and then the specific add-ons to that that some of you may not be familiar with. Then there is the Idenalynx XR Plus video. I don't know, is anyone familiar with the Idenalynx XR Plus? Does anyone own one? Okay, I see a few hands. So if you owned an original Idenalynx, or if you do own one now, you might know that part of the struggle is having to manually adjust it when it's set up. So the Idenalynx XR Plus takes care of that. Next is the LED video displays, which we're really proud of. We've actually been working in-house with CAD to design the sort of framing, aluminum framing, right, around that. And we're really proud of how they look. And if you check out in the back there, next to Paul, it's getting a suntan on the display right now. So take a peek at that later on. And then finally is the finish lane software enhancements that come around with that. And again, I know most of you guys are going to be familiar with the gist of the sort of new features that come out in the release notes, but again, I think it's worth mentioning because maybe it can remind you to ask the question of how the heck does this work, what am I doing, whatever. So, all right, so let's start with the updated vision camera package. So we overhauled them across all sports. We replaced the older cameras, the 2000 pluses, the Fusions or the old pros, with new user-friendly Vision series cameras. And we love these cameras and we think that the users seem to really like them too because it makes it a little bit easier to align at the finish line and then you get some better software features with that to just kind of make it an easier process when you're capturing. So. And we think that they're competitive at every level. As you know, we're a big package company, so not everyone has $100,000 to spend on a system, unfortunately. That would make our jobs a lot easier. And we think that every level of package is competitive with what you're gonna see out in the field. So when you're bidding on something, and you know the budget isn't there to throw the kitchen sink in, we think that you know you're gonna get something that customers and venues will really love. So most of the packages will come standard with 2,000 frames per second color images, Easy Line, of course, people love, Power over Ethernet, full integration with third-party accessories, and then adding features as needed. You know, maybe you want to go with a competition, but then add in a couple, you know, remote positioners or something that people like. And then finally, there's the instant upgrade code, but I'm going to mention that later. I think that's a really cool feature. And, you know, here's the updated Grand Prix Elite for athletics. We believe it's the most powerful high-end timing package in the world, and we feel confident saying that. You know, you have a 500 and a 600 in there. You can see all the accessories there, very souped up. Lux Boost, high res, Wi-Fi, level. We got everything, so. And then I just remind you guys to check your binders because in there is gonna be the marketing brochures for all the sports. So if you're curious to see what the gold rowing looks like, there's a little bit of everything in there as well. So, and if you have questions as to why something's set up the way it is or why the frame rate doesn't go up to, you know, 20K on this package, then feel free to bug Kevin about that. All right, and then just quickly, we also updated the field packages as well from all the way, all six of them, and there's gonna be a really strong emphasis on live field results. So you can see four three-sided displays, which are, I don't think we could even afford to ship a three-sided display down here, but they are a thing of beauty, and it's all custom aluminum framing around it. It's all weatherproof, I believe it's IP65 weatherproof, does that sound right? Okay. See, I know what I'm talking about sometimes. And I think that it definitely inspects the display back there, because you'll see that's really high quality stuff. So. This was my mediocre Photoshop attempt. As you can tell, it's not actually live capturing right there, but you get the gist. So that's the Vision Pro camera, and we're really excited about this because, you know, some of you guys probably own the older Pro, but we think the Vision Pro is beautiful because, first of all, obviously the 20K frames per second is, you know, great, but it's all of the easy-to-use features, I think, that really make it sort of the best camera on the market today. So as you know, probably it comes standard with 3,000 frames per second. LuxBoost 4, which is one of the two LuxBoost options, it goes up to LuxBoost 8. That comes with the onboard level and then electronic filter control, which is not something that I'm super familiar with. The electronic filter is great for sort of the light changing, is that right?
In the low light situation.
In the low light, absolutely. There you go. And then, of course, we offer the 6K and 20K upgrades, which is great for horse racing, motorsports, or some of the more novel type applications like the wingsuit racing or airplanes or whatever you guys can come up with. I know that some of you guys have been involved in some of the borderline insane type sports that have been timed with finish links, so you'll have more ideas than I do. But and then another thing that, so this is not something that I'm super familiar with, but we see a lot of questions or complaints about lenses and lens mounts, like, does it work with this lens? Or I bought an $8,000 lens, why doesn't it work on my camera? And I think that's something the tech guys deal with, but I think that the fact that we worked hard to get compatibility with a lot of different mounts, I think says a lot, so you can use your expensive toys that you already have on the camera, but if there's specific questions about ranges or whatever, again, that's a kept question, so. All right, and then so, like I said, it maxed out at 20,000 frames per second and 2048 vertical pixels, which is generally gonna be way more than enough for what you need unless you're timing sort of like an F1 type situation. And then there's things like LuxBoost 8, which gives you 8 times the available light you could upgrade to. And I've not personally used LuxBoost 8 before, but I know someone like Graham probably, right? Where's Graham at? Do you use LuxBoost 8 at all?
Well, we're family road cameras that good that we've never passed 4.
Well, there you go. So that's a product development issue. It's too good that you don't need LuxBoost 8. All right. All right, there you go. So so it's available, and that's something that, those are the kind of updates that if you're selling into a market that really values the high specs, maybe that's something that the 20K LuxBoost 8 is something that maybe they're not necessarily gonna need every day, but that's a great add-on to make them say, listen, this is some of the most cutting-edge tech in the sports timing world. I think you want it. So. Then there's actually some other interesting things like the battery and level we sort of talked about, but the video display module, I don't know, is anyone familiar with VDM at all? Anyone? Not a lot of hands actually. Okay, so VDM is essentially just, I'll save that for later, but listen, you can basically run a modified Result TV type display script directly from your camera through scoreboard, which I think is brilliant, so we'll take a look at that later. So we're gonna look at some of the upgraded add-ons. So again, I think most of you are familiar with LuxBoost, but LuxBoost enhances the available light in a low light situation anywhere from 1, which is the default, up to 8 times. And you know, I think most of the customers are probably only gonna need, you know, 2, 3, 4. I don't know what the standard is there, but it'll vary obviously depending on you know, where you're capturing and what the light is like. But another thing we introduced recently was auto LuxBoost. So if you are having LuxBoost enabled, you can tick a box. If you're not sure exactly if you need 2, 3, or 4, auto LuxBoost will automatically determine. determine how much light you need to optimize the image. And so if you got someone capturing there and you don't want to worry about as the light changes, ticking it up or down, then I think that's a nice little addition there. We've also heard that it eases the phase light distortion. We obviously still offer PLC, but does that sound right, Kevin, that bit beat up?
It will look good, but a little bit. There's a situation you still would need
PLC. Okay, exactly, all right. And then we've just seen, at least based on social media and that kind of thing, that timers seem to love it. It's one of those things that it enables, you know, where you might have to stop capturing at, you know, 5 p.m., 6 p.m., it can get you in through the night, so. A big improvement. All right, so I don't know if Jeff's just running here, but so this is the electronic viewfinder. This is something that Paul Lambert specifically pushed for because in some of the really difficult stadium installations, you might be hanging a camera up in the rafters, and so it's essentially a digital version of the through the lens viewer type thing. So you plug it into the back of the HDMI port, and it's going to show you a live 1D or 2D view of the finish line. And you know, if you're just a regular track and field guy, you probably don't need it because your laptop is 2 feet away. But at some of the more complicated installs, this is kind of a great thing because you can see what's going on, and it'll replace the old through the lens viewer, which I know is sort of a fan favorite. A lot of people, I don't know, who still uses a through the lens viewer in the audience. Yeah, a lot of people. It's okay, don't be shy. Don't be shy, you're loud. But this is sort of a modern replacement for that, so. All right, so next is the video display module. And I know I think I asked before who's familiar with this, but I don't know if my shift. No, it's sort of working there. Okay, so what happens with VDM is that you can send live results and images directly from your Vision or Vision Pro camera to a compatible HDMI display. So literally you're going to plug in the HDMI to the out port in the back of the Vision, and then you can connect to a scoreboard, even a TV, or you know, I guess a projector if you wanted to. People have used projectors, there you go. And so you can control that via finish links with some custom scripts, and you're of course welcome to make your own. But then, you know, I think what it is that not everyone has the money to put in a $200,000 Daktronics type display. So this will give, you know, it's part of bringing the technology to every level where a smaller track meet might be able to have a finish line display or a field display out there that's not going to cost them an arm and a leg. Let's see if this works here. So the VDM also lets you send images directly to the scoreboard, and I think this is my favorite feature. So if you can see there, they're basically cropping the same way that you export an image. And then you're saying send to scoreboard or send scoreboard image. And then it sends it right to your display in real time. So if you have a great finish there, say you're scrolling the live results, and then you can, boom, send the image there for all the parents and fans to see. I think that's a really cool little feature there. So, all right, then there's some other sort of advanced features for the Vision Pro that, so internal GPS, that's gonna be something maybe Jason would use, right? So you're gonna be able to sync with the GPS externally if you have multiple cameras or other devices, laptop devices. External Wi-Fi, it's not, you know, the Wi-Fi adapter is super simple. It doesn't, you know, I think there's something to be said of the look of the old ear antennas, but this is, you know, we tested a bunch of different options, and this is just dead simple, and it works. And at the end of the day, you don't want your Wi-Fi cutting out. So obviously, I think most of you would be proponents of always hardwiring, but if you do need a Wi-Fi solution, I think this is going to work for you. It's gonna let's see, and then there's the internal radio links. So that's something, is this like brand spanking new?
Brand new.
Okay, do you want to talk a little bit about how that would work then?
Well, it works. It's seamless the way it works. It works like any other radio links, but there's one less piece to set up. The deck radio is embedded inside the camera, and we're using a version of the radio module that allows you to change the frequency dip switches through the FinishLink software. As you all know with your Enq radio, Deq radios, you have to match your frequencies, and sometimes you need to change them because of whatever environmental is going on. You need a different frequency, so you can do that right from the radio links tab in FinishLink now. So we have the first camera with internal radio links is the Vision Pro back there, and it's up and working, and you can come take a look at it.
So is that available for the 50500 as well, or is that, okay. And then, of course, with the Vision Pro, there's still all the other Vision add-ons that people love, which is Easy Line, onboard level, electronic filter, and then the internal battery, if you guys need that as well. All right, next is going to be the Identolinks XR Plus video camera, which is sort of the next generation there. And again, this is a very great Photoshop by me there. All right, so you know, it functions the same way as the old Identolinks and Identolinks Plus Pro, whatever they're called at this point now. But the main selling feature there is going to be the PIRIS lens. So instead of having to manually adjust if someone kicks it or there's wind or you're not quite getting if it's a little bit blurry, you can now remotely control the zoom, focus, and iris directly. And I think that's going to save a lot of headaches and frustration there. So if you haven't taken a look at it yet, we have one out back. So tinker around, and it's going to work the same way that adjusting another camera, an Ethernet camera, would work. And as the extended resolution version, this comes in up to 2592 by 1944 at 15 frames per second, which is pretty gigantic if you're talking about capturing a race there. And then there's full 1080p at 30 frames per second. So then again, that's going to be more than you need. And then total, there's going to be 9 resolution settings if you want to, if you're capturing thousands of people, if you want to tick it down and save some hard drive space. Again, it's going to work a lot like the original Identolinks, just better. All right, and this is another one we're pretty excited about, which is the Lynx LED video ports. So this is something that we just introduced in the past, I don't know, eight to 10 months, does that sound right?
Yeah,
maybe about a year. So the LED panels are modular, full color, and high resolution. So you're gonna get a 6 millimeter pitch there, which means that you're gonna be able to get a little bit better quality images and videos on there. So the body is aluminum frame, which is custom designed by Lynx. And so Mac Boyette, who's not here, I believe just did the CAD design in-house, yeah. Right? And so it's all custom cut and designed and shipped to us. And I think we're really proud of the quality. If you want to just give it a little tap when you go back there, I think it looks beautiful. And so the way that it works is going to be any HDMI input will be able to send graphics to it. So that's anything from Result TV, VDM, Field Links, or just even a netbook. You could theoretically just play Netflix on it, is that right?
Yeah.
Probably wouldn't want to buy it for that, but you could if you wanted to bring it back to your hotel and watch Netflix, that's fine. All right, and then the reliability there is IP65 weatherproof. I just looked at the manufacturer specs. It says something like 100,000 hours or 11 plus years of LED life, but then I think the important part there is, you know, you have 4 panels, and if anything were to happen, you could easily swap one out, and you're working good to do. So, and of course, the goal is to bring live FinishLink results to the entire field. So, whether it's a finish line display, live field results, laser lengths, anything. So, we're just trying to make it more engaging for fans, for athletes, for everyone who's there. All right, so then as you probably know, we have the one-sided out back, but it actually comes in a 1, 2, or 3-sided display. So if, for instance, you wanted to start with the one side and you thought, I think we need a little bit more juice, and then you could add your second side there, and suddenly you're covering a whole other side of the track there. And then so each side combines 4 vertical panels. So if you actually you watch the setup video on YouTube, but there's 4 LED panels that go in there. That's something that's programmed by us to sort of set it up a certain way, but once it's up, it's ready to go. And the total meter is, or the total size is going to be 2 meters long by 1 meter high of the LED panel itself. And then with the frame, it's a little bigger than that. And then it's actually also 5,000 plus nits of brightness, so that's going to give you plenty of brightness to be in indoors or outdoors and get your message to as far away as you need it. So even in writing something. Again, writing VDM and Result TV scripts. So it actually, right now, it'll run on AC power, and then you can also daisy chain multiple units. I know no one has multiple units at this point, but theoretically, you could have four one-sideds throughout your entire infield or field in general, and then you daisy chain them via an Ethernet cable, and then they'll all display the exact same thing. So if you have a major 100-meter event type coming, you can then, you know, flash the live results or results image across the entire stadium. See Kevin and Paul for the demo. That's the last and most important one. Please play around with it. They here I'll make it. All right, and then I think that you'll find that they're professional, elite level displays for a great price, and the one side starts at $9,595. All right, the next is the smaller LED panel. We don't have an official name for it yet, but essentially you're getting the same high resolution type LED panels. It's taking one of the vertical panels and just flipping it sideways and turning it into a smaller type field display. So you're getting 84 pixels by 168, and it's perfect for like a VDM or Result TV type finish line thing. Probably even field, you know, if you're doing a field event type thing, you have next to it.
I really like it as a finish line display. You plug it into the camera and as you can see, you get three lines of results, custom messages.
Yep. Oh yeah, actually, the custom messages, I think, is a really cool part as well. And then as you can see just from the photos, again, it's all custom designed by us. So you got aluminum frame, which is gonna be a lot lighter than some of the other options. Then you got some sturdy handles on there as well, so you can lift it up and lug it wherever you need to go. All right, and then this is gonna be the last part where I'm just gonna quickly talk about the finishing software enhancements. I think we're getting close on getting close on time with Paul Lambert's up next, but we'll go through this. All right, so FinishLinks, as you know, is the engine that makes all of the hardware shine. So the camera specs are essentially nothing without the software that accurately and powerfully turns it all into data for you. And I think that it's important to know that you might find other specs, camera specs out in the field that look similar or possibly even allegedly have a higher frame rate. But I think at the end of the day, if you don't have a piece of software that makes it all accurate and reliable, then it really means nothing. I think that's really what FinishLinks is. It's gonna be something that gives you the peace of mind that you're timing correctly and accurately. And I think it's sort of important to note that a lot of you know the basic features, but that you know, you really need to sort of jump onto the more advanced features to really unlock. So Vision Pro specifically, there's Lux Boost 8, which is 8x the available light, Auto Lux Boost, Double Mode, which will give you 20,000 frames per second, then Double just in general will also require half the light for the same frame rate. So like Graham was mentioning, he's capturing at maybe 6K, but then at the Double Mode, he only, you know, didn't even really need to use Lux Boost because it's only requiring half the light there. There's also some new wide pixel modes, black level control, which is something that's beyond my pay grade, but essentially you're gonna be able to tinker with the darkest levels of the photos there. And then there's also some remote focus features where you can add an F-mount adapter so you can use your expensive Nikon lenses and still be able to get remote features there. All right, then there's some visual indicators in the software, which I think are good additions, and I think that's stuff that people push for. Finding the camera's function, so maybe you don't have a camera that's showing up in the hardware control, you can use the Find Your Camera function and it'll still find it, and then, right, is that essentially if it's... And then you can restart it from there, and then maybe you'll be good to go, and it'll be there and get back in your hardware control. The VDM, the video display module, I think that's something I'd really recommend you guys checking out back. Again, you're just sending live results directly from the HDMI to the display. There's some lap time updates, and then I don't know how many of you guys use Radio Links, but a lot of the US track timers is pretty essential. So now you can monitor your performance, your battery life, and sort of the packet info to see if it's working reliably and well. All right, and then finally, the last thing is Vision Instant Upgrade Codes. I don't know if anyone is familiar with this here. Has anyone used the Instant Upgrade Code internationally? Okay, I'd see like one, maybe two hands. So, a really cool thing is that now, I believe starting in 10.01, is that maybe 10 or 10.01 in finish links, you can now do instant upgrade codes to your vision camera. So, what happens is you purchase it, we'll send you a digital code, you enter it into your finish links option there, and then suddenly we'll be able to unlock things like lux boost, frame offset, electronic filter control, VDM, viewfinder, and PLC. So instead of having to ship your camera back, we can send your code and you'll be good to go. And this is beautiful for if you have people in the field that buy you an upgrade, you ping us for the upgrade code, and then we'll send it and you'll be good to go. So. All right, and then I guess the last thing is I just encourage you to use the breakout sessions to demo new products and try to learn some new skills this week. Come out knowing your stuff better and be able to take something at home, take something home that you can share with your team. So thank you guys very much. Any questions? No? It must have been very thorough and engaging. There we go. Thanks, guys. Quickly run to the bathroom, now would be a good chance.